Thank you, Tom. Tom has been around MSOE for a long time, and he came and did a feature on one of our student athletes, on Matt Shaner. And Matt Shaner was a heavyweight wrestler, three-time national qualifier, All-American. And Tom, I don't know if you remember this, Mr. Pippins, but what Tom said as part of his segment that night is he said, "Could we finish it off by me wrestling Matt?" I said, "Are you kidding me? Nobody wants to do that." So I'm glad you're still here. It is a real privilege for me to introduce Joel Vande Boom tonight and introduce him into MSOE's Hall of Fame. I met Joel when he was a senior in high school, and Coach Mario Trificante and I, we went and watched some of his matches, and one of Joel's coaches, Duffy Brilsford, came up to me and he said, "Joel is coming to MSOE," and he said, "You are really going to enjoy him." He said, "He's a hard worker, dedicated, great attitude." He said, "You will really enjoy him as an athlete." Coach, you were right on. He was all that and more. Speaking of all of Hall of Fames, Coach Duffy is in more Hall of Fames that he's run out of wall spaces. It was great to see you here. But Joel, indeed, he was everything that Coach Duffy said he was going to be. I just want to share with you, you've heard some of his accolades here, but let me tell you a little bit about him as a student. Joel completed the two-degree, five-year program, where you get 2 degrees, a degree in architectural engineering and a degree in construction management. During that 5 years, Joel received all A's with the exception of one AB. Graduated with a 3.99 grade point average, obviously on the dean's list every term that he was here. I spoke with Sandy Everts, who's here tonight, our director of marketing and public affairs, and I said, "Sandy, since 1903, no, Sandy and I did not start that date. I said, "Sandy, my recollection when we talked about this, about how many 4.0 students we've had since 1903 is about a dozen." And Sandy said, "No." She said, "I don't think we had 10. I don't know how many we had at 3.99, but it can't be very many." So Joel, you were one of the top, you've been one of the top students since this place was founded. So that's an amazing accomplishment. As a wrestler, you've heard some of the things that he has done there. Mr. Pippin shared them with us. Joel was actually a three-time finalist in a conference tournament, as you heard, sophomore year and senior year. He was the conference champion. Senior year in the conference tournament, with about 15 seconds left in the match, Joel and his opponent were wrestling hard. Joel got cracked in the head, and he sustained a concussion. I remember him walking back to the middle of the mat, and he was kind of walking on rubber leg street. And I said to the official, "Hang on, give me a timeout." And I looked at Joel, and I went out to, and I said, "Joel, are you okay?" And Joel's first words were, "Please, coach, don't stop the match." I said, "Don't worry, I'm not going to stop the match, but I said, I just want to make sure you're okay." So he was okay. He was a little foggy, but I said, "Joel, here's what I want you to do. As soon as the whistle blows, just grab onto that guy's leg for 15 seconds, and you'll be good to go." So Joel won the match. He beat an individual who was a national qualifier. He was voted the outstanding wrestler of the year by the coaches of the conference. That's quite an accomplishment for him. Unfortunately, that injury prohibited Joel from competing in the NCAA regional tournament, which was the next week. And I'm convinced that Joel would have. The NCAA regional tournament is the qualifier, much like Coach Gardner was talking about cross country, how that's a qualifier for the nationals. That's the qualifier for the national tournament. So Joel could not compete in that. And I'm convinced Joel would have been an All-American. And I say that with great certainty because the week before we were at the Wheaton College Invitational. And that's regarded as the most difficult NCAA division tournament that there is in the country. At that tournament, Joel beat two national qualifiers and an individual who was a two-time All-American, an individual who had placed fifth and second in the nation. Joel beat him by the score of 11-3, which in wrestling is, when you have a differential of 8 points, it's a major decision. So he really lit that guy up. And Joel, I will never forget, Mario and I were like proud papas. We just sat there and said, this is amazing. He's just torching that guy. His coach was from Ohio, the athlete was from Ohio Northern. And I just saw the coach, he had the program in his hand, and he was one of those where he's like looking like, who is this guy? Who is this guy that's beating my guy up so much? So, Joel, I know that's haunted you, you know, but I would say don't let it, because your accomplishments have been incredible. And as Dan Harris had said to you, you don't have to prove that on the mat that you're an All-American to prove what a man you've become. You've seen some of the things that Joel has accomplished as a wrestler, so I won't go over them more. I do have one question, though. You heard Dan Harris talk earlier about the COSIDA Academic All-American, what it takes to be. He said you have to be an all-conference athlete, and then they look at your grade point average. The only question I have is COSIDA Academic All-American second team, 3.99, Joel. You slacker. Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great privilege that I introduce an individual who is the epitome of what a student athlete should be all about, Joel Vande Boom.
I have to do this. I'm back in Wisconsin, so go Pack, go. Woo! Recently moved to Ohio and been all over, and just it's great to be back here at MSOE where my career and education all started, really on the next step to my professional level. And I'm just really excited because the first day I was here, you know, I had a bunch of butterflies. Now here I'm back with all my friends and family, having this tremendous honor with my coach off to the side, and have that butterfly sort of feeling again. So first off, I'd like to thank Dr. Veets, MSOE, the Hall of Fame Committee, Brian Miller, Dan Harris. It's amazing how MSOE Athletics, as we heard throughout the whole night tonight, it just keeps growing. Its students are amazing. The Hall of Fame Committee team members here. Every year, it keeps growing, getting better. And the buildings, as you can tell, the Curran Center and the soccer field across the way are just some impressive athletic facilities, and I think it really helps bring athletes here. Now, going back several months, I remember the call from Coach, and it instantly just brought a smile to my face because I was excited to talk to him, just catch up. We haven't talked in a while. And I still distinctly remember this because I had my son, who was a year and a half old at the time, and I had him wrestling his stuffed animals on the floor, and he was winning every time. I was just so happy. He just kept flipping the dog, or it was a stuffed animal dog, over and just kept pinning him, and I'm like, man, I know Kaylee might not want that, but he was winning. So I was excited. And he just had some great news for me. He mentioned I'm going to be joining himself along with fellow great athletes in the MSOE Hall of Fame. And I was just instantly honored, so excited, and just humbled, because to be part of this group is truly a remarkable experience. And to even go as you walk through here, a lot of the Hall of Fames are on that beautiful mural at the Curran Center when you walk in, and just to be known and just to be mentioned in that group is amazing. So I know there was a 5-minute limit, and I just wanted to share a little story. Actually, Coach mentioned a little bit before. All of us have had great times here at MSOE, and I just was thinking what story to tell. And there's so many of them. Maybe it's the Florida trips that we had and during our competitions. Maybe it was the karaoke of us singing Sweet Caroline. Some of those guys were amazing wrestlers, being better singers. Maybe it was our Saturday night dinners, because as you know, as wrestlers, when you compete on Saturday, you can't really eat or you have to watch your weight. So Saturday, we always go and have a nice dinner. And for some reason, I was always the birthday boy. Never got that. To my great teammates, my great coaches, we just had so much fun. I mean, we had little UFC competitions sometimes in the wrestling room. It was just a lot of great times, a lot of great memories that I'll always cherish. But of course, I'd be up here for an hour plus. As you can tell, I love to talk. I'll bore everyone, and you'd be pretty much shooing me off the stage. And also, I learned a very interesting fact. It used to be the average attention span of an adult during a speech was 12 minutes. Well, now that's moved down to 5, so I have to really get going. So it was actually my story. I wanted to start. It's actually the ending of my career, as Coach mentioned, and it actually has finally came and brought closure due to this event, and I am very thankful for that. Now, it was 4 scores and 4 years ago, divided by 14. So that's roughly 6 years ago. It was a cool, crisp Saturday morning in February. We're all bundled up, going on this little white bus off to Howard's Grove for Lakeland for the college wrestling for the conference wrestling tournament. I was extremely excited. All my teammates, you know, we're going to go there, we're going to win conference as a team, we're going to bring home individual titles. We did our typical thing. We went there, weighed in. I ate my favorite thing, honey on a bagel. Had some Gatorade. I was all good to go. It was just one of those times you just feel, I was a senior at the time, everything was clicking. You know, as an athlete, you just have that little, that swagger once you get stuff going, and I was just excited. This is my year. I had a couple more matches, just went out. I could be that national champ I always wanted to be. So after eating, warming up, remember going on the mat, remember seeing Coach just said, go get him, you got it today, and that was the last thing I remembered. I actually remember waking up in my bed, headaches, just, you know, nauseous. I had those symptoms for weeks. And I always try to push through that because I knew that national qualifier was the following week. So it just really, you know, all those years of hard work, just it really bugged me that I had to end that quickly. And also, I just don't have a memory of that. Now, it was my 5th concussion, which just, I mean, the other ones weren't as bad, but that was a bad one. And the national qualifier, you know, I still remember that Saturday morning. It was a week after, and all the guys are getting ready on the bus. You know, it's cold out. It's now March. And I go up there and, you know, just say thanks for everything and good luck. You know, you guys all do great. And luckily that day, we still had a national qualifier in Virgil. And I was very proud of him on that. But that was one of the hardest things I had to do. I had to walk away from one of my biggest goals that I wanted to achieve in my life. And until this week, I have really been honestly holding that grudge. I had that competitive void that just I couldn't fill with softball, with baseball, basketball, pickup games. I just couldn't fill it. And usually you get that closure, you know, that final hand raise when you win a match, that little tear. I don't know, I cried. I got very upset when I lost. The final hug from a coach, just even the final sitting on the bench or the hearing that buzzer sound, I never had any of that. I never received that. So in my mind, I can still compete. My body tells me otherwise. So recently I saw an episode on E60. It's an inspirational sports on SportsCenter, and it was actually on Travis Roy. And he just had a very inspirational story. Thought of my cousin Pat on this, and just the way I was pushed through. He played a mere 11 seconds until his college career ended. He became paralyzed. And he's the only player to have his number retired at Boston University. And he had one line that just caught my eye, and this was early this week, ironically, heard it as I was trying to think of what to say. He said, "It's great to have goals and have passion behind those goals, but sometimes those goals are stopped by challenges, and it's how you react to those challenges that defines you." So looking back, it was a journey with my teammates, friends, family. I'm on my way to try and become a national champ that I am proud of. It took me till now to realize that. And it's not the fact that I was not able to achieve my overall goal. And I still remember this 2 years ago, my dad said it best when he said, "I do have that national championship I was always striving for. I finally had it with my beautiful wife and my son." So my new goal I have set forth is just to be the best husband and father I can be. And I know it's to take a lot more years of training than 7 to 10 for wrestling, but I'm all in for it. And now enough really for the long story, because I know we have to get going, but I have to give many thanks to the people who supported me and made me who I was today. And that's, of course, my parents. Thank you. I think you've been to all my wrestling competitions, all my sporting events. You've been with me through thick and thin. And you're always there and behind me in all my choices I make. And I hope I'm as great a parent as you were to me. For my amazing sisters, who have more state titles and national titles than I think you know what to do with. You just won one today. You always came to the wrestling mat and watched me. And I am forever grateful. In fact, you know more wrestling moves than I think you probably take everyone in this room. I know it was always your top choice, but he came. Thank you. To my beautiful wife, who has broadened my horizon and continues to challenge me every day, and who brought a beautiful son into this world, and he brings joy to everyone with just his smile. Actually, his 2-year-old birthday was this this afternoon. He just turned two. And I also want to thank Mike and Kathy, who have raised an amazing daughter and have helped tremendously send her change to Ohio. To Pat, who's been like an older brother for me and just taught me to enjoy every moment in life. You never know when it might be your last. And Jason, who knows how badly I compete. Sometimes I'm unfair. I know that. I just want to win. And to all my uncles, aunts, cousins, my grandparents, to all our Minnesota family. We moved to Minnesota there for a while, especially Zachmans, who are here tonight. I just am so grateful. And I just want to say one last time, thanks for this tremendous opportunity to be included in this great MSU Hall of Fame with tremendous athletes who are even more amazing people. And I just want to say cheers to the past, the class of 2015, and the future classes to come. And I would like to end with a saying from one of the greats, Stuart Scott. It really touched me years ago, or I should say last year. Have a great rest of your night, and have a great rest of your life. Thank you.